the iPhone Pro Max is getting all the attention this year, which makes sense. As usual, it's the biggest, slickest phone with the best camera. And it's got the newest marquee feature, the Dynamic Island. It's also got a newly stabilized selfie camera, an always-on display, and it's capable of satellite connectivity. Plus, for the first time, Apple has ditched a physical SIM card in the US. But there's an old saying, no man is an island, and maybe he should hold off on buying the fancy phone if he wants one that's actually going to last. As we reported earlier, the iPhone 14, thanks to its secretly redesigned interior, now opens from both the back and front, making both the back glass and screen immediately accessible. It is far and away more repairable. That said, there are plenty of questions to answer about the Pro Max. How has the always-on display affected the hardware, for example? And what's with the camera bees? Join us as we tear down Apple's most hyped phone of the year and find out. Speaking of always-on, Creative Electron has come through with some incredible imagery, giving us a peek at that hefty stainless frame, embarrassingly empty SIM reader socket, and some new front-facing camera magnets. First up, as always, the friendly Do Not Enter pentalobes. Heat things up, grab your favorite suction cups, and crank this puppy open. Gotta love a gentle opening. I'm not expecting much new in here, but it's always good to watch for surprise cables. Unlike the vanilla 14, this is exactly the same old process as iPhone's 13. It's interesting that Apple left their amazingly innovative new design off of their flagship phone. Is it just me, or is sliding this pick a bit easier than I remember? Before long, the Pro Max is an open book. Well, sort of. You've got to remove oodles of screws from this extra large shield. Don't lose track of them. Then the battery and screen are safely disconnected. And here's what's behind the fabled Dynamic Island. Despite the liberated notch and always-on display, there's not a ton of new on here. I'm sure we're all desperate to see what's behind the mysterious plastic block where the SIM reader should be, but it seems either adhered or soldered, so let's try and pop out the logic board and investigate. The board is tightly paved with connector after connector, and no matter how many screws I remove, we're getting nowhere fast. So, out comes the upper speaker and the front-facing camera. Quick detour to admire that newly stabilized selfie cam. Ooh, ah, that uses magnets we saw in our X-ray. More screws and, yep, still no connector under here. We're gonna need to go spelunking. A few more screws and bye-bye camera shield. Out pops the massive camera assembly. These things are even thicker than last year and give the non-pro models some serious tilt.
We were also curious about the crazy shaking and rattling that's been flooding social media from these $1,500 phones. So we downloaded TikTok, flipped the camera a few times, and sure enough, the bees are angry.
It doesn't happen every time, but it is pretty intense. And with more people than ever watching videos on social media, it's a pretty big deal. By the way, the most recent update does not fix it. Underneath those cameras, there's still a big ol' well in here. That's not gonna make battery removal any easier than last year. Speaking of battery, to tackle that, let's first remove the Taptic engine and lower speaker. Man, as much as I love reusable fasteners, this layer cake of hidden screws is a heck of a puzzle. Cross your fingers and toes, time to pull out the four battery strips. Ready? Oops. Oops. Yeah. And close enough. The 16.68 watt-hour battery is free, and just as L-shaped as ever. Finally, we can free the millimeter wave antenna and get this logic board out. Yep, it's a box. These solder points are empty, so I'm not likely to damage anything if I just go for it. So, pop goes the Lego. This is literally just a plastic spacer to keep the screen supported. Looking at how dense the logic board is, you'd think Apple would come up with a better use for this beyond a gram of nothing. How about this pitch? Maybe a little extra storage? A microSD card reader looks right at home. I, for one, could use a serious storage bump. Okay, so what about this whole satellite thing? Well, first go watch our satellite explainer if you haven't, and second, brace yourself. There's not a ton of new to see here in the Pro Max. Apple's satellite functions operate on 2.4 gigahertz, and since Wi-Fi operates in the same range, there's not a lot of new antennas in here. The logic board is about the same, with two notable exceptions. As expected, the A16 is here. And Qualcomm's much-rumored X65 5G and satellite chip is also in the house, enabling Globalstar SOS. Only one question remains. What's the score? Well, unfortunately for the pros, the vanilla 14 has the best feature, repairability. Since the Pro line continues with the 13-era construction, their score is also stuck in the past. At 6 out of 10, these pros aren't terrible, but being the flashy feature line has left them stuck with the old layout. The Workhorse 14 is sure to shine with its new design, and the pros of next year will hopefully benefit from a more advanced design. Who knows? Maybe repairability will be a feature worth bragging about on stage.